Pisces, I was going to say Taurus, but you know, you are the High Priestess, and that is a two, and Taurus is the second house. Venus is exalted in Pisces. Venus rules Taurus, the second house. So let's flip over your cards. You got a Taurus card. What do you know? This is the Five of Pentacles. And this is talking about difficulties within an institution, difficulties with family members, difficulties within the consistency of something. Feeling challenged in a situation that you would like to move freely in, that you can't. Wanting to have personal freedoms that you necessarily don't have right now. And you don't believe this to be your reality. But it's actively what is being sort of like forced to be your reality right now. You know, you're like, this is not how my reality is supposed to be. This is not how I am supposed to be living. Who am I within this reality? How can I be flexible in my mind when my reality is limiting me in some sort of fashion? Right? What do I have to see that I have been ignoring, or what am I only choosing to see, and what may I be choosing to ignore? What is unavailable for me to see right now because I have not been able to access part of myself that I haven't been giving value to? The Fool. This is Uranus. Where is Uranus right now? In Taurus. Uranus is the higher octane of what? Mercury. This is Mercury in Taurus, y'all. Mercury wants to be free. Taurus wants things to be this way. Mercury wants to break out of that. Taurus is like, but this is the way things are. You have to work within this. That's what it is. And Mercury's like, man, I used to feel free. I used to feel flexible. I used to feel beautiful. This could be like, you know, you don't feel beautiful right now. Your life just doesn't feel that way. The beauty has been taken out of the way that things were comfortable. No longer being able to be in that comfortable state. The Fool wants you to let go of all of those things that Taurus holds on to. That's why Uranus is exalted in Scorpio and it's in its fall in Taurus. So Uranus being in its fallen Taurus, Uranus asking you to change the way that you see things. Because the way that you see things might be holding you back in terms of you being able to see things in a different way that is going to set you free from the prison of the way that you were seeing things before. Okay? And it's kind of like, what needs to change? What do you need to commit to now? Right? You need to commit to letting go of those things that don't make you who you are. Right? Your things don't make you who you are. You make your things what they are. Without you, your things will be nothing. But without your things, you are still who you are. You can have more things at any other time. And if these things that you are missing are things that weren't good for you anyway, then let them go. Why do you still want them? You know? Listen, my son is in my 12th house, so I'm talking to me too. The Fool, this is Aquarian energy. This is asking you to, yeah, let the change happen. Let, you know, let things transform. Let things, you know, be different. It's time for things to be different, Pisces. You know? Now it's time for you to kind of like be ready for anything. You know? You might be feeling a little bit vulnerable to the risks that you foresee, right? Because Uranus is very much on that psychic energy sometimes, you know? Being able to see that there is something more for you. Something to be discovered, you know? Finding your way. You're finding your way. Yes. Eight of Wands. Finding your way. Mercury in Sag. Moving. Information coming in. Opportunity. The power of information. Knowledge is power. Being able to grow. Right? Knowledge is growth, is power, is movement, is expansion, you know, is strength. And this is saying that you're going to have to move forward with strength of the mind, right? The power of the mind, right? What the mind is able to withstand. You're stronger than you thought. Or you might be stronger than you think you are. Because right now it's saying that you don't feel as strong as you should. There's power in weakness. When you're able to acknowledge weakness, you're able to acknowledge power. And the eighth house is one of power. The fifth house is one of power. And the Fool is powerful because it just is. Okay. Pisces, thank you so much. If you'd like to get a reading with me, email providencetarotkendrick@gmail.com. Like, share, subscribe, and comment on YouTube. Follow me on Instagram, Providence Tarot. And I'm also NYC Kendrick. I'm doing a special right now. It's 20 minutes for $20. And the lower tier of that is 10 minutes for $10. Okay, thank you everybody. And stay safe. Be smart.